Bill.
I'm Aimee.
Hi, I'm Ronaldo.
And I'm Zidane.
So in June 2017, we started a journey that we like to call Chasing the Sun.
Yeah, it's basically our version of world school for us and our kids.
In lockdown, so it's been really quiet.
Yeah, and I suppose we just have a lot of
Free time.
Free time. Like, what's it like? How do you explain
yeah.
it?
When yeah, when you're stuck inside, there's not really a lot to do. Jet set, watch the sunset, kinda, yeah, yeah.
Rolling eyes back in my head, make my toes curl, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you got that yummy. What took you to Morocco, where you are now?
Volunteering. Yeah, we're in Spain, and we were volunteering in Spain at the time. And I think I was just looking at random flights, and €9.95
€9
could get to Morocco from Spain.
Spain. It's like,
whoa,
let's do it.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Wow. So that's how we got to Morocco.
What inspired you to go on this journey?
A number of things. It wasn't just one. I mean, when my nan passed away, that was the one for me. Like, at my nan's funeral, I couldn't like speak in my mother tongue, so I thought I had to go back to Tuvalu.
And it was also partly because we just wanted to spend time together as a family.
So we were in Tuvalu for four and a half months
in Tuvalu,
and then a month in Fiji.
Yeah, Laos is also another raw, untouched kind of country yeah. where it's
not developed,
not as developed as some of the other Asian countries.
How many countries have you visited in total now?
In these past 3 years, I think we've been to like 30,
38,
30 something countries.
I think it's about 38, 39 countries now, and these last 3 years.
A lot of it was in Europe, because yeah. we leased a car and we traveled around Europe.
Hey, tell me, yeah, how are you guys surviving financially over there?
So we are living off our savings.
Yeah.
And I mean, to be honest, it's not expensive. It's very cheap to live in Morocco. All we pay for is food. But I mean, that's why we've been able to sustain this kind of living for so long, is because...
Through volunteering.
So we're just at my great-grandfather's house, and Ram is just going to do a little blessing for the spirit of her dad. Give me an interesting snack that you guys have eaten.
In Laos, the one that got me was this. Nice. They had grilled a duck, and then they had diced it up like a duck, and they put it in like a salad almost, and it looked really nice and yummy. Then they went and started pouring like the blood of the duck on top of the salad, and we were like, oh my god, it's amazing. Like the taste of it is, yeah, that was probably the most interesting one this time around.
What's the best thing that's happened on your journey thus far?
I think the first place that's, I mean, we think of, for example, Tuvalu, going back to the richness of living in an isolated island, like that was the place that we say planted a seed in our souls. And just seeing how everyone is with each other, that takes community to the next level and family to the next level. They're our chefs, so they cook for us every day.
We want to be chefs and own a restaurant.
What's your best dish that you've cooked for Mum and Dad?
It's like this little, it's almost like flat bread. It's like flat bread, and it's really, really crispy.
But it's in layers. It's like a raw tea, but it's in layers.
So are you ready to come home?
I don't want this ride to end, because it's just been such an amazing experience.
You know, if it's one thing that we want to inspire other people to do, is that, you know, far out, if we can do this, so can you.
Anyone, you know, the fact.